Good morning, children. Welcome to our social class. Today, I am back to you with an interesting lesson, that is third lesson, tanks and groundwater. Topics to be covered in today's class, tanks, that is Cherubulu. How were the tanks built? How did the tanks help? Declining of tanks in our times. I think, children, you all know, you are very frequently heard the word Cherubulu. It is a way you are familiar with this word, Cherubulu. You will see this Cherubulu in villages. You enjoy this Cherubulu view in villages. People using this water for their drinking purpose and bathing, etc. Now, tanks. Cherubulu are nothing but tanks. These Cherubulu are also known as tanks. Tanks are used for irrigation purpose. For 4,000 years, our ancestors have tried to use runoff rainwater by building tanks. How these tanks have come, how these Cherubulu have come into picture, our ancestors, they thought to store the rainwater, that is runoff water, by building tanks. So they thought very high that this will be useful for future generation. So they built tanks to store the rainwater. Tanks are used for agriculture purpose. This tank water in villages, we'll see, they use this water for agriculture purpose, for their daily requirements. Emperors and kings also built a large number of tanks. You can see here in this picture the tank. These tanks were built in earlier days by the emperors and kings, or by the headman of that village like sarpanch, or nowadays ministers. These people are building these tanks. Tanks are nothing but Cherubulu. The other name for Cherubulu is tanks. How were the tanks built? Who built these tanks and how these tanks were built? See, children, see the picture here. How the tanks were built. They used the some stones, mud, everything to build these tanks. It is a clear picture for you. You can see here. Observe this one. Tanks were usually built by building a strong wall of stones and mud across a small stream. You can see here the water stream, and across this stream a tank was built. A wall was built with the stones and mud in such a way that with a wall on just one side, a large lake could be formed. Here, a tank were built across a lake and small stream. See the picture. Villagers contributed for the expenses, maintenance, repairing the tank bunch, or removing silt from the tank bed. Not only the minister or government contributes for building, in some places, villagers also come forward and they will contribute for this building and maintaining purpose and removing silt from the tank beds. Person is appointed to regulate the use of the water from the tank. A person in villages, we'll see, a person is appointed to look after the maintenance of this tanks, and we'll call that man as a cherubu caretaker or neeru katta manishi. We'll call him a different name, that person. Then come to the another topic. How did the tanks help? Now tanks are built, and we learned who built their tanks and how these tanks were maintained. And what purpose these tanks, how these tanks help us? Just see here how the tank water is helping. Here a hose, it is drinking water. And you can see this picture also. The many birds here, they are staying here. Tanks help us for drinking water, animals drinking water, irrigation purpose, helps in increasing the ground level in the well nearby. These tanks are used for drinking water purpose. These tanks help animals to drink water. Here you can see here the horse. And not only that, these water also used for irrigation purpose and for agriculture. And these tanks increase the groundwater level. And with the help of these tanks, a well, it gets water every time without drying. Tanks help us to prevent the runoff rainwater and the soil erosion. These tanks also help to prevent the runoff rainwater, because the tanks will store the water, the rainwater which is running, they will store, and it will stop the soil erosion. Tank silts can be used as a fertilizers to the soil. The silt which is formed nearby the tanks is used as a fertilizer to the soil. Here you can see here many birds are there, and how the silt is formed here, and it is used as a fertilizer to the soil. Declining of tanks in our time. See how, why these tanks are declining. Nowadays, we are not seeing these tanks. What happened to these tanks? Let us see. People started occupying the tank lands for building houses or for agriculture. Yes, what happened? People started, population has grown up, and people started occupying these tanks and started constructing the houses. And now we are living in a concrete jungle, you all know. And these tanks are occupied and constructed building. This is the reason nowadays we are not seeing the tanks. People are throwing the wastage into the tanks, and they are filled with the waste deposits. Not only that, the people are throwing wastage in the tanks and polluting these tanks. Because of throwing the wastage, these tanks lost the storage capacity. What happened? The storage capacity of tanks was decreased, and slowly they dried up, and now we are unable to see these tanks. Okay, children? I think you understood about the tanks. Tanks are nothing but cheruvulu. And who built this cheruvulu? And how these cheruvulu are helpful to us, and how they declined, we learned. Okay, children, I think you understood. Watch the video carefully. I'll come back to you with another topic. Thank you. Stay home, stay safe.